No conceptual exercise can deny the I-ness of the body. It is you, Mohit, who is yearning for that state. So the Mohit is always around. Whatever you do, it's around. So the next step is to say, okay, if Mohit is around, if this body is around, then this body is doing something. It's got a raison d'être. It's got a reason for its existence. So what is that reason? Why is it here? If dissolution of identity is the aim of an existence, then why even be in a body? Then that whole identity and all the ego identification connected with the body is done away with in one go. One can be a spirit. Then the problem is resolved.
So I looked into this when you mentioned that that is not the right approach towards living. So my...
I didn't say that. I said, if you want to live in this world, you want a partner, you want children, you want to take up a job, then you can't take up a practice which results in a dissolution of identity. Because you need identity to take up this presence. You cannot be there, I'm not this body and there is no I. How are you supposed to get a partner and children? Then you have to go to the Himalaya. I know some good caves there. I'll introduce you to sit there. There's Ganga Jal also nearby, flowing by. You don't even have to walk far to drink. Most of the youth of this country have a deep yearning for self-knowledge. It is hardwired into your genetics. And the first thing they're looking at is, main Himalaya chala jaunga. Main Himalaya jaunga. That is the answer. I'll go to the Himalaya. It's not the answer. Firstly, there are not that many caves for 300 million young men. And secondly, that's not the place where you go to find self. That is the place where you go to dissolve identity.